Hi guys, welcome to another video. I'm Ashima and today we will be talking about how to spend your holidays or free time productively. Now this list is targeted to students who've just finished their boards examinations and are looking to begin their college in a couple of months. If you are preparing for your entrances and do not have free time, then you can just skip watching this video because this video will be helpful if you have a lot of free time in hand. So let's start. Number one, learn about your native place, explore your town, know new cool facts about your native place. I know this may sound basic, but trust me, it is a huge icebreaker when you go to a different place, a different college where you know no one. Check this out. Hi, I'm your new neighbor.
Hi, welcome. Where are you from?
I'm from Solan, Himachal Pradesh.
Oh, Himachal Pradesh, Shimla, Manali, I've been there.
You seem to be into books, right?
Yeah, I do like to read.
Do you know Salman Rushdie's ancient home is in Solan, not Shimla?
I always thought it's in Shimla.
Oh, yeah.
And I think Solan is also the place where Solan number one is from, right?
Yeah, you're so right. Number two is organize a workshop. Now by workshop, I do not mean you have to make a physics or a chemistry project, but something as simple as how to make paper bags out of old newspaper in some NGO or an orphanage or anywhere where someone would be willing to learn. Now this will look very cool on your CV, but more than that, it will give you a sense of satisfaction which will be with you for a couple of months. So this is a really, really good idea. I wish someone had told me when I had holidays and when I had free time. So go for it. Number three, extension of the previous point, is volunteer. Now, it's not difficult in these days to find volunteering opportunities. Organizations like Feed India or Robin Hood Army are looking for people who will help them to reduce food wastage. So you can become one of the Robin Hood Army. Help in reducing food wastage in your local area. Also, if you're in writing, you can help an NGO or some small startup managing their content on their website. Do engage in these activities as they're a good learning experience, will add to your resume, as I said, and will give you immense amount of satisfaction. So do it. Number four is reading. Now it is easier said than done for people who are not into reading. If you are a non-reader, like I was when I was back in school, I'd never ever read a novel which was not a part of my curriculum till I started my college. I know it is very embarrassing, but that's the truth. But how I got into reading and how you can get into reading is start reading newspapers. Read any newspaper, though my personal favorites are Indian Express, Live Mint and Business Standard. Start with your entertainment section, sports section, anything, but just start it. Slowly move on to the national news, the editorial pages, the opinion pages, which will start help you in building your opinions, and then you will start getting a recommendation of books to read. In no time you will become an avid reader as I have become. So definitely give at least 1 hour to reading newspaper every day. Number five is, as cliche as it may sound, but to develop a hobby. Now, if you're into dancing or music or painting already, good for you. But if you are a lazy person, things like gardening or making stuff out of trash or something as simple as photography using your phone can be a good start. It can get you into the groove of getting out of the bed and, you know, doing something every day. This will also help you to figure out what works for you and what does not. What are your likes or dislikes, which will eventually help in choosing societies in your potential college. Whether you choose your drama society or dance society or a photography society, this will help you in making those decisions. So do develop a hobby. Number six and the last point, because the video was becoming really, really long, is learn about different career options. Now everyone knows how to become an engineer or a doctor. But how do you become a Supreme Court judge? Or how do you become a creator of advertisements which major brands use? How do you become one of those? Research about it and figure out where your interest lies in, and then pursue them in your college. It is as simple as that. I think that's it for this video. I do have a couple of more points, but the video is becoming really long as I mentioned earlier. So do comment and let me know if you want a part 2 of this video. Give it a thumbs up if you like, and let me know if you're practicing some of these, if you found them helpful or not so helpful. Just let me know, DM me on Instagram as most of you already do. And yeah, that's it. See you in another video. Bye-bye. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye-bye.